shivers down your spine. Shrieking skulls will shock your soul, seal your doom tonight. Spooky, scary skeletons speak with such a screech. You'll shake and shudder in surprise when you hear these zombies shriek.
Whatever you want to call it, sexy skeleton and makeup tutorial. So is this sexy? I think so. It's more of like a modern type of smoky eye instead of a full skeleton face with the hollowed out eyes and all that. So I thought it was just kind of a cool look. I thought it was fun to do. It's relatively easy. So watch to find out how I did this look. Hello beauties, let's get creepy. Okay, so I already moisturized my face and applied eye cream, so I'm ready to go. I'm grabbing my Tarte Poreless Primer, and I'm putting that all over my face and rubbing it in. Next, I'm grabbing my Anastasia Beverly Hills Concealer and my Kat Von D Concealer Brush, and I'm starting off by concealing the tail ends of my eyebrows, and then any spot that I'm afraid might shine through with this look, like I have a lot of red spots, and especially my lips, which I want definitely concealed in this look. And then I am just rubbing that all in and blending it in with a beauty blender. Next, I'm grabbing 120 Classic Ivory in the Maybelline Fit Me Foundation Liquid, and I am putting a good amount of this all over my face, neck, and chest. This is a pretty full coverage foundation, but it's also really affordable, and you can get it at practically any drugstore. And I'm just blending that in with a beauty blender. Don't forget to get your ears so that your ears match your face. Then I'm getting my Ben Nye setting powder, and I'm applying that to any spots that I get oily. Originally, I wasn't going to do this, but I got afraid that with the amount of detail I'm going to be adding later, I didn't want my oily foundation to not be set and have the detail all ruined. So I'm putting that practically all over my face. Next, I'm grabbing my Anastasia Beverly Hills Dip Brow. It's a little sample pack, and I'm applying that to my eyebrows, and it is pretty dark, but I think that adds a lot of drama to it, and I'm pointing them downwards so I have a permanent frown, like a little skeleton. Next, I am just wiping away all this extra setting powder, and then I'm gonna get my MAC eyeshadow palette, and that's what I'm using for basically this whole entire look. So right now I'm sketching out my jawline and cheekbones. This is just so I have a little bit of a map of where everything is gonna go. Then I'm gonna grab a bronzer because I feel like it's more natural and it's easier to do. So I'm putting that where I normally put the bronzer and within the mapped out area. So I just have an idea of where my cheekbones are and where they should be. And this also helps for shading later. Now I'm continuing to map out the jawline cheekbone, and I am going to do a line from my lips. I'm going a little bit more up than my lip is, and I'm doing straight lines down with little triangles. And these are gonna be my teeth, and then I am sketching out my nose, and it's basically just two points and a rounded bottom at the bottom of your nose. This is what it looks like. Next, I'm doing shading. So what you're gonna wanna do for this is grab the darkest shade eyeshadow, and you wanna do that with a palette that you don't mind kind of using up. I've had this palette for 2 years, so I don't mind using a lot of the product, but you're gonna grab a dark brown shade and go right on the mapped out area or like the outermost part, and then grab a slightly lighter brown shade and go under that.
and then a even lighter brown shade and go under that and drag that down to your jawline. And this is just gonna have a better fade effect or shadow effect. Next, I'm continuing that shading with the teeth, and I'm gonna go everywhere that I mapped out before and then do a little V at the top of the teeth to look like roots. And I would use a very light shade brown for this. And then I'm just connecting them at the top. Then I'm grabbing a black gel liner and I'm going to trace over where I mapped out for the nose and fill that all in. Next, I'm going to use that gel liner and I'm going to trace out everything for the mouth. So that line going straight across, the teeth, and I also trace out the cheekbone. So that sideways L, I go over with a black liner to define it more. And then I grab this off-white shade and I am covering that in for the teeth and I'm going straight up all the way past the root. And so you see it kind of dilutes the brown for the root, but I think it looks really nice. Next, I'm grabbing that black liner and I am putting it on a eyeshadow brush and I'm very, very lightly adding that black color into the inside of the cheekbone. And I'm constantly blending that in and grabbing the darkest brown shadow and blending that into the black. So a lot of this is just blending to try to make it look more natural. Next, I'm grabbing this eyeliner and I am lining my upper and bottom waterlines, and it makes my eye tear really bad. It makes me tear while watching this too. Ugh, oh my goodness. Then I am mapping out my eye socket with a light brown eyeshadow. This is going to be a more wearable eyeshadow look, but I want to at least have some type of base of where my eye socket is so I can make sure that's covered with shadow. Next, I'm grabbing the lightest brown shade and I'm using this as a transition shade and going above my crease with it, basically where my eye socket ends. So I'm going pretty deep into my inner corner and pretty far out on my outer crease, and also going under my eye with that too, wherever my eye socket is. Next, I'm grabbing this slightly darker brown shade and I'm adding that to the outer part of my crease and my outer V. And I'm winging that out a little bit to make it more dramatic, but also to fill in my eye socket. And I'm putting that under my eye to the end of my eye socket as well. Then I'm just blending this out a little bit to make it look prettier and blending out under my eye. Next, I'm grabbing a very dark brown shade and applying that to my outer V and winging that out. And I'm applying a bronze shade to my inner corners and I'm connecting that to the outer corner to make kind of like a halo eye effect. Then I'm shading my nose with that light brown shadow and I'm going above my eyebrow and around my head, kind of making it look like a sinus or something. I'm trying to carve out where the bones are most predominant in my forehead, and I'm also gonna really shade my temples and the top of my forehead to just look more like a spooky skeleton. Now I'm shading with a darker shade right above my eyebrow to give myself more of that brown look. And I'm using a mix of a very dark brown and a more like bronzy brown just to make the shadowing right for my skin tone. Next, I'm using this gold shade on my lids and it has a foiled effect and I really think it just makes everything pop. Then I'm using that gel black liner and lining my upper lash line and I'm winging that out pretty far and then just connecting it. Then I'm filling in my bottom waterlines with this black gel liner. And then I am just blending in a soft brown shade under my eyes, filling in my eye socket with it. It just makes me look more frowny and more dramatic. Then I'm curling my lashes, applying mascara, and putting on falsies. And the falsies I feel like really, really make this eye look. Then I'm grabbing my glow kit from Anastasia Beverly Hills and a tiny brush, and I'm adding this white highlighting shade to any spot that I really want highlighted, and since I didn't use any type of white face paint, this kind of adds that white gleam to it, so I'm putting it on the high of my cheekbones, on my nose, and in all of these little teeth to give them a little glimmer. I'm also bronzing out my chest and neck, so I'm putting bronzer on the sides of my neck and under and over my collarbone and my first rib, and I'm blending that all out. And that is the whole look. I hope you enjoyed.
liked this video, please give it a big thumbs up and subscribe if you have not, and comment if you want to see something else. And have a very fun and very safe Halloween. Bye, beauties. Love you. Mwah.